Right. PyCon US version 2024. I guess by now you're all waiting for the release notes. All right. What do I have? Again, my name is Mariatta, but I guess you all know by now. But again, just want to share if you somehow you would like to follow along on these slides, if there's any information you would like to take notes of, I put a barcode that links to this whole slides up there. And if you're looking for the release notes from the earlier versions, they are all now on the slides here from 2024.0, 1.1, and 0.2. So three versions. All right. I never thought I'd get to do this, like releasing three in the weekend. But this version is all about celebrations. I'm not gonna put in any new features right now. It's all about celebrations. First of all, congratulations to all the speakers, all the presenters, all the tutorials presenters, posters presenters, and the charlas. We have 138 speakers and charlas, 24 tutorial presenters, and 40 poster presenters. Congratulations. Great job. And really just want to start saying thank you to everybody who made this event possible, especially to our sponsors. As I had initially mentioned, this year's sponsorship is lower than before, as shown on the slides here. Last year, we received little more than $1 million, and this year it's $918,967. But we are definitely grateful for the support with it. As I mentioned, it shows that you're committed to continue supporting Python. So thank you so much. Thank you to our visionary sponsors, NVIDIA, Bloomberg, Meta, Google, and Fastly. Not only we receive less sponsorship dollars, we also have less sponsors. So last year we have 85 sponsors, and this year we have 81. And there are 64 sponsors booths this year. And in the expo hall, we actually have, again, something's less here. 8 startup rows last year and only 7 this year. However, we granted more community booths to come to PyCon US and to talk about their community. So this year, last year we only have 9, and this year we have 11 community booths. And if you stopped by the PSF booth, you might notice that there was an opportunity for you to become new PSF members. So we have 20 new PSF members this year that sign up through the booth. And in case you were wanting to become a member, I put up the barcode to become the member, and we have 2 options for becoming a supporting member. The first option, it is $99 per year to become a supporting member. And for this amount may be okay in North America, but in other parts of the world, this is a difficult number, even though they are wanting to become a member. So there is now a sliding option that starts at $25 if that's what you would like to pay. And becoming a PSF supporting member comes with a lot of benefits. You get to support Python and PyCon US, of course, and you will get to vote in the PSF board of directors, so you get to have your voice heard. So please consider becoming a member. All right, as mentioned, we broke records. So this year's registration, we have 2736 registrations and 2055 2,551 badges printed, compared to last year was 2,159. And the first time, I should have made that bigger. The first time attendees in person is 1,752. Which is, it's more than last year. Last year it felt like a lot, and there are even more first-time attendees. Last year we have 1,672 first-time attendees, so numbers are increasing. However, because of the ratio, last year we have 77% first-time attendees, and this year the number of first-time attendees are 65%. It's still a good majority of you all, so thank you for joining us for the first time. All right, looks like I do need to put on a patch release. So, what you're seeing on the slides now, 110 on-site volunteers. This is actually last year's number. This year we have 135 people who sign up to be on-site volunteers. So thank you so much for everybody for helping to make this event possible. Travel grants awarded. We granted 224 travel grants. In addition to travel grants, we also granted 636 complimentary registrations to PyCon US. And despite of the lower sponsorships we received, this year we granted $351,436 compared to last year $261,000, so it's about 100,000 more grants awarded. PyLadies auction happened last night, and as kind of hinted by Lynn, we broke records. Last year, we only received 29 items that were auctioned. This year, it's almost doubled. We have 44 items that were auctioned. And the maximum bid for the auction was this cuckoo clock, which I described in my yesterday. This raised $3,400, and if anyone who haven't seen it, I'll try to see if that's possible. So it's it actually plays a cuckoo, and I'm going to try to describe it. So it's a cuckoo clock with, I don't know how to describe this. It's very colorful. There is some snakes decoration, a bear, a turtle on top of it, a unicorn, and I can't see the animal. And there's a bluebird, and there's a banner that says import anti-gravity. Thank you. $3,400. This is also more than what we received last year. Last year, the maximum bid was $3,000, so $3,400. So thank you for the support. So I just wanted to illustrate like the record that you all broke. In this slide right now, I have historical PyLadies auction proceeds starting from 2016. It grows from like 16, so from 2016 all the way to 2024, except for 2020, where there was no PyCon, didn't happen. There was no PyLadies auction, but the numbers goes from like 16,000, 21,000, 30,000, 46,000, and dropped to 11,000 in 2021 because it was online. We got 44,000 in 2022 and 36,000 in 2023, and this year, we received 60,000, which is much more than ever before. So thank you for helping us, supporting us, breaking this record. So what do we do with PyLadies donations? And a majority of it are being used to provide travel grants. And this year, PyLadies travel grants recipients, there are 42 PyLadies travel grants recipients that comes from the funds of PyLadies. And the total number of PyLadies travel grants awarded is $69,000. So, really wanted to thank everyone for being here, like for staying all the way till the end. It's been really meaningful to me. And before I continue, I also would like to thank a few more groups of people who made without this event, without them, this event would not be possible. Our vendors, Altitude C, they handle all the AV production for this event. If you've seen the little animation at the beginning of the keynotes, they did that. It's amazing. Thank you. White coat captioning, in case people don't realize, our captioning is not done by AI. There are real people sitting with us. I know there's one of them there. Thank you for helping us. And thank you for our venue, DLCC, which is the David Lawrence Convention Center. I really love it. It's one of my favorite venues, as well as Stetson Convention Services. They really help with all the convention services, with all the signage, and handling the expo hall, working with all our sponsors. They've been really great to work with. Thank you. Also wanted to say thank you to our designers. All of the imagery, like these colors that they created, the branding, is done by these three people, Georgie Kerr, and Anastasia, and Kirilo, who are from Ukraine. And I know, unfortunately, Kirilo couldn't come due to situations in Ukraine, but Anastasia is actually here right now. I don't know if she's here, but she's been enjoying this conference alongside you all. Thank you for them. I think I just have one more gift to show you all. Let's see if this actually works. All right. Thank you. cool. Thank you. Oh, that's one of my favorite parts of this whole thing. But really, just wanted to say thank you. This is, in fact, the final release notes that I'm doing for PyCon US 2024. It's really been such a fulfilling journey for me. I never thought this is a thing I could ever do. And I just wanted to say thank you for everybody, especially the PSF, for giving me this opportunity, for trusting me, and for letting me do all of this. I don't know why, but I think throughout this journey as a PyCon US chair, you really showed me what it is, what it means to be inclusive, to be accepting. Because I could have lots of ideas, but if you are not enjoying it too, it means nothing. But the fact that seeing you all actually, I hope you notice I brought a lot of my personalities into this whole thing. It is not like any other PyCon US ever. The fact that I see you all enjoying this too has been really rewarding and fulfilling. I really thank you all for this opportunity. Thank you. Thank you. All right, this might be PyCon US version 2024 final, but what about version 2025? So I would like to welcome Elaine Wong, who I've known her for years as well, just almost as long as I've been in the Python community, and I know you're all in good hands. I fully trust her, and if you all see the challenge list that I have, one of it is that if you find someone who programs Python for television, it's her. So now you all get 5 points. So welcome, Elaine. Thank you for your actual handing it over.
Thank you so much, Mariatta. All right, one more time for Mariatta, because she did a fantastic job all these years. Amazing human being, amazing chair. All right, I'm gonna make this quick because I'm kind of hungry. So I also get horrific stage fright, so if you can't hear me, just start clapping so I know. I hope you had a great, oh God, it started already. I hope you folks have had a great time so far. Great last few days, hopefully. I've met a lot of you, and it was great meeting new folks in the Python community and hearing your feedback. And please keep telling me what we can do better next year. You can reach me at my handle there. Let's see if this works. Oh, clickers. So I know for some of you, you love PyCon US so much, you just want to keep the party going. Well, let me tell you a secret trick. Even though PyCon US is the largest Python conference, it's not the only one. There's actually going to be at least 40 conferences related to Python happening around the world between about starting probably tomorrow and all the way to the start of 2025. This is not a complete list, and it's kind of small, so I do apologize. I'm not going to read them all out loud because I can't read that. But feel free to grab the QR code that Mariatta shared earlier, and all these lists are available. You can also go on GitHub. Of course, I made the link this size, so I can't see it. But I believe it's GitHub for Python conferences, and there's a list there as well. And this is the second slide. So I highly recommend checking it out. Lots of these regional conferences are for the community, by the community, for the community. So there are a lot of them are volunteered ones. So I highly recommend checking them out by either attending, volunteering, or speaking at one. Or you can be someone like myself who schedules vacations around regional Python conferences. I highly recommend it. It's a great way to meet new friends. And as my mother says, a vacation should also be educational. Thanks, Mom. So But there is Pylaten, which is probably the closest one to the beach, and there's probably also a Pi Beach, but it's not on the list currently. So as Mariatta says, don't forget about the PyCon US challenge that is on the back of your cards, your nice badges. As you know, just by sitting here, you've got at least 6 points. And you can get a head start for next year by going to a regional PyCon conference, or organizing one, or convincing your company to sponsor one. So you'll for sure, by next time you come back in 2025, ready to get some ice cream with us. And we will be honoring the challenge during sprints, so please pop by the staff office when you get 20 points. We'll give you a lovely card, and then it's a nice 15-minute walk to Millie's homemade ice cream. And of course, we'll be back next year in Pittsburgh for 2025 because we loved it so much. Let's do it twice. Less than 1 year. So May 14th to 15th for tutorials, May 16th to 18th for a conference, and May 19th to 22 for sprints. So please plan on coming back because I would love to see you all. So thank you and come again. But before we break, I have some breaking news. That is actually the old breaking news logo for my work. I just had to include it. I have the noise already in my head, the nice da-da-da-da-da-da-da. But breaking news. I just want to introduce the 2026 location. It will be in Long Beach, California. So we're heading back to the West Coast. See, I told you there's going to be a beach. And so that is it for me for now. Hope you'll hear lots from me, don't worry, in the next year or two. And thank you again so much for coming out. But before you head out, I just want to introduce Chalmers, who will be talking all about the next couple of days, which is my favorite part of PyCon. It's all about sprints. Thank you so much.